I know that we all predicted this would happen, but part of me still thought they would not do it. And here we go. NBC News is reporting Democrats to introduce bill to expand Supreme Court from 9 to 13 justices. President Joe Biden announced the formation of a commission last week to study the court's structure, including the number of justices and their length of service. Absolutely incredible. And why do they want to expand it to 13 justices, you say? Well, it's because, according to the left, 13 districts, 13 judges. Well, it's very convenient timing considering the current court makeup is 6-3 with a conservative majority. Adding four justices right now would mean a 7-6 liberal majority, and then the Democrats would control every branch of government. It's a power grab. It's obvious. My friends, there is a corruption that is seeping through our country, and it is eroding it and destroying it, and it's worse than it's been, at least as far as I can tell. I am but a humble 35-year-old man. I have not been alive as long as many, I think most people are older than that. Maybe not. Maybe it's actually, you know, because people have kids. Okay, but anyway, there are a lot of older people with a lot more experience. A lot of people are in their 50s. Maybe you've seen worse things than we've seen in this generation. But I'm watching this stuff. This sick, craven, depraved quest for power. The lies, the manipulation, the deceit, the fake news. The obvious and overt attempts at subverting our country, our rights. And I'm like, I've never seen anything like this. Now, I've seen the political arguments. I remember Bush v. Gore. I remember all of that. And there was still most Americans agreeing with each other on most things, except for a few issues. And yeah, I mean, the Bush v. Gore thing was serious. But today it's like everything's just imploding. I mean, Trump 4 years, the media lying incessantly. The media's current obsession with Donald Trump, a man who's literally not the president. How is it that I turn on the news and they're like, Donald Trump? And I'm like, why? It's been 3 months. Stop. Corruption. Depraved power quests. When Joe Biden got elected, the fear was that they would try and pack the courts. And many of us, most of you probably assumed this was going to happen. And I'll say it again. Part of me just did not think it would actually happen. I want to read for you what their plan is, and we'll talk about this, but I want to show you a few other things too. I want to show you this cartoon really quick. This is from Blog for Arizona. I don't know whose comic this is. It says blogforarizona.net. Prima donnas Joe Manchin and Kyrsten Sinema make no sense at all in their defense of the Senate filibuster rule. I just want to show you this comic from Mike Lukovich. Senate Dems are all in a cage wearing orange jumpsuits, and Joe Manchin has the keys. The lock says filibuster. And Manchin says, but if I unlocked our cell, being keykeeper would stop being a big deal. Man, when I saw this, I thought it was absolutely hilarious in how insane and craven and depraved and vile these people are. The Senate right now is split 50-50. It's a bad thing. Kamala Harris is the tiebreaker. The filibuster rule requires 60 votes to pass legislation. This is a good thing. In order for there to be a functioning country, an organization of any kind, you need to have compromise. We can't just have Democrats steamroll through things that would piss off the other side, 75 million people in this country. Voters, I should say, because there's a lot more than that when it comes to splitting Democrat and Republican down the middle. There are people in West Virginia who don't want to live like people in New York City. So when you have a 50-50 Senate, that means the Democrats need to compromise with the Republicans and vice versa. Considering the Democrats have the House, it's mostly going to be Democrats requesting help from Republicans. Getting rid of the filibuster would mean the Democrats could steamroll everyone, and they want it. They're mad Joe Manchin and the filibuster rule. This would mean that with only 50 Senate votes, the Democrats could do whatever they wanted. For the most part, they've already got this dumb BS where they're like, the Senate parliamentarian has decided we don't need 60 votes. The system is fractured, broken, and it's a farce. And they're spitting in our faces every day, and they don't care. You know why? Because people like you or I, we are unfortunately few and far between. Well, relatively. I understand there's a lot of people who watch my channel and watch other channels. Maybe you're getting your information from a conservative pundit, but at least they're being honest. Maybe it's a progressive pundit, someone like Jimmy Dore. Hey, they're being honest. He's being honest. But The reality is, I think most people are still getting their information from mainstream sources. I know it might appear on social media, but it is coming for the most part from mainstream sources, and they will believe what the establishment tells them is true. And as the establishment becomes a vessel for psychotic fringe cultists, this is where we are. The Democrats, it used to be, you know, look, Democrat and Republican, and they mostly agreed, and they bickered back and forth, and it was very performative. Then Trump and Bernie came along. Trump actually won. Right now, we have Lindsey Graham. So here's this other big story, right? We'll read about the Supreme Court. Donald Trump has a plan, had a plan. He talked with the Taliban about a full withdrawal from Afghanistan by, I believe, May 1st. The media is now announcing that Joe Biden has planned a withdrawal from Afghanistan by September 11th. At first, it seemed like Joe Biden was ending the war in Afghanistan. That's how they're reporting it. In reality, he's not. He's delaying it. The end was already confirmed. The Taliban is now warning, if you overstay, we're, you know, we will retaliate. This is what the media does. This is how the lies perpetuate. And they're acting now like Joe Biden's a hero. Granted, I said thank you to Joe Biden on Twitter because I'm like, let's just keep pressuring him. But Lindsey Graham comes out and defies Joe Biden, saying, we need war. We need to be at war. Rah! What a piece of trash. We need to stay, otherwise the terrorists will win. Shut your mouth, you moron. These people are sick and disgusting. I remember when Lindsey Graham walked up and like high-fived Kamala Harris. It is a performance. It is trash. These people don't care about you. They hate you. Hence, what they're doing with the Supreme Court. Now, the funny thing is, it's not like Kavanaugh and you know, like Amy Coney Barrett are somehow populist figures. They're still establishment figures. And the Democrats want control, so they're going to go for it. Here's the report from NBC News. Congressional Democrats will introduce legislation Thursday to expand the Supreme Court from 9 to 13 justices, joining progressive activists pushing to transform the court. Now, should slow down. I really believe this will fail. Okay, that's why I mentioned the Joe Manchin thing. He's going to be like, I'm not going to do this because, you know, my constituents won't like it. People seem to think that Democrat, you know, is the end all be all. Joe Manchin is a West Virginia Democrat. How this guy got elected is beyond me, I guess, because he used to be the governor, I suppose. So people voted for him because they liked him. He's a Democrat, but he still represents West Virginia. So try again. It's probably not going to work. But I digress. Let's read more. They say, the move intensifies a high-stakes ideological fight over the future of the court after President Donald Trump and Republicans appointed three conservative justices in 4 years, including one who was confirmed days before the 2020 election. The Democrat bill is led by Senator Ed Markey of Massachusetts, Jerry Nadler of New York, of the House Judiciary Committee, co-sponsored by Reps Hank Johnson of Georgia and Mondaire Jones of New York. The Supreme Court can be expanded by an act of Congress, but the legislation is highly unlikely to become law in the near future, given Democrats' slim majorities, which includes scores of lawmakers who are not on board with the idea. President Joe Biden has said he is not a fan of packing the court. You know what? I'm glad they're at least trying so we can see how sick and vile these people are. But if they actually succeeded, they would rip this country in half. They would it would cleave the right through the fissure that already exists in hyperpolarization. And boy, if you want accelerationism, if you want escalation, this is your play. Bravo, Democrats. Now, I don't want those things. I'm more worried about China. If the United States splits up, I know that a lot of guests of the show on IRL say peaceful divorce. My concern is what happens to the world if the U.S. isn't there to stand up to China. I mean, it feels like we're losing that fight anyway. This would accelerate it. They say it represents an undercurrent of progressive fury at Senate Minority Leader Mitch McConnell for denying a vote in 2016 for Barack Obama's pick to fill a vacancy, citing the approaching election before confirming Trump nominee Amy Coney Barrett the week before the election last year. They don't tell you the context here. I am no fan of Mitch McConnell. In fact, I very much do not like him. But the idea was we control the Senate. Barack Obama made an appointment. If we vote, the vote will be no, so we're just not going to do it. Mitch McConnell said when the Senate is split from the presidency, meaning one party controls the Senate and the other controls the presidency, then you're at an impasse in terms of Supreme Court justices. With Amy Coney Barrett, the Senate was Republican and the presidency was Republican, so they were able to have that vote. Not like I care, based on, you know, well, I'm not going to speak to I think it was Merrick Garland. I'm not going to speak to his, you know, his current statements make him sound like a lunatic, but My understanding back then was that Republicans were like, he'll never pick a moderate like Merrick Garland. And then Obama did. Like, all right, here, we'll do this guy. And then they're like, no, no. There's got to be compromise. And that means for Republicans, too. They probably should have compromised in that capacity. And at the end of the day, it's all part of the legal process. So there's not much to say in terms of the Republicans were in power and they said no. You can't then get mad that Republicans remained in power and said yes later on. What they're doing now is basically saying, we don't care who's in power. We're going to steal it anyway. Now, that is different. To be fair, however, it is still within the power of an act of Congress to expand the court. I just think it's sickening. I do. I think the Republicans should have held a vote for Merrick Garland. And I think right now what the Democrats are doing, this tit for tat will rip this country apart. Whatever. They say the anger has taken hold within the Democratic Party, and the new push indicates that it is not dissipated in an era when the party controls the White House and both chambers of Congress. The lawmakers who tend to announce the introduction of the bill outside the Supreme Court building will be joined by progressive activists, you know, blah, blah, blah. Sure. The bill marks a new era where Democrats finally stop conceding the Supreme Court to Republicans, said Brian Fallon, a former Senate Democratic leadership aide and co-founder of Demand Justice, who described the court as broken and in need of reform. Our task now is to build a grassroots movement that puts pressure on every Democrat in Congress to support this legislation, because it is the only way to restore balance to the court and protect our democracy. I'll stop right there. My friends, some people are saying 13 districts, 13 judges. Okay, actually, I kind of agree with that. It makes sense to me. Apparently, originally, there were six districts, so they had six Supreme Court justices because each oversaw one of those districts and in terms of, you know, appeals, because the Supreme Court's an appellate court. Okay, here's my idea. I actually don't mind the idea of expanding the Supreme Court because we do have more districts and each Supreme Court justice could oversee one of those districts. How about the solution is, if we're going to expand the court, we expand it evenly. Republicans nominate two, Democrats nominate two, and that's it, period. If the Democrat argument is, you know, you got 13 districts, you know, 13 justices. OK, well, then let's make sure it's a balance of power. No, they won't do that. Of course they won't. They risked everything, the Democrats did, thinking Hillary Clinton would win and then they would get three, maybe even four new justices. Ruth Bader Ginsburg held on for a very long time, but Trump ended up getting three, shifting the power of the court. And it was a powerful play by Republicans, but it was within their right to do. It's within Democrats' right to do right now, but this is not part of the normal process. When a Supreme Court justice retires or passes, the president nominates a new justice. If the Senate is controlled by the party of the president, then they have the power to vote and confirm. If they're in opposition to that president, they likely would reject the confirmation, the nomination. That's what they're empowered to do. Democrats, it is within their power to expand the courts, but it does seem a bit more abnormal to throw on four justices right now with Joe Biden as president, because that would just be a major power swing, which for most people, we've had nine justices for some time. It seems unfair to change that system now. It's a power grab. You know, Republicans were talking about maybe they should have packed the courts while they controlled the Senate, but they didn't. Maybe they should have. Maybe they should have said, we're going to add four more justices. Oh, the left would have screamed and cried foul. Exactly like what's happening now with the Democrats are doing. So it's like, if we're going to play this game, why not play it to its maximum? Well, Republicans, in my opinion, are weak. They're poor leaders. And just all around, you know, Lindsey Graham and Mitch McConnell, just ugh. Just awful. They say, last week, Biden announced the formation of a commission of liberals and conservatives, sure, to study the structure of the Supreme Court, including the number of justices. The size of the Supreme Court has fluctuated since it was established in 1789 and remained at nine since 1869. You see, that's the problem. It's been that way since 1869. Why change it now? McConnell has strenuously warned Democrats not to add seats to the court, saying there is nothing about the structure or operation of the judicial branch that requires study. He quoted remarks from Justice Ruth Bader Ginsburg, who died in September, and liberal Justice Stephen Breyer, both of whom voiced skepticism about expanding the court. President Biden campaigned on a promise of lowering the temperature and uniting a divided nation, McConnell said in a statement last week. If he really meant it, he would stop giving oxygen to a dangerous, antiquated idea and stand up to the partisans hawking it. I don't think he actually cares. These people want power. And there it is. Joe Manchin is stopping Democrats from steamrolling this country. It's not just about Republicans in the Senate. It's about the fact that there are different states in this union. And not everybody wants to be ruled by urban liberals. If you want to go live in New York and live in a cubicle that smells like sour milk, I don't care. Go do it. I did it before. Eventually, I said, you know what? I kind of don't like it. I'm going to leave. Then I left and I went out to the middle of nowhere. Well, guess what? In the middle of nowhere, you kind of need to protect yourself when there's no local police department. So you buy guns. Now you've got these lunatics saying, we're going to ban guns. We're gonna limit blah, blah. Okay, look. Here's what will happen. First, let me show you this. House Judiciary GOP tweets. Ryan Grimm just reported that Jerry Nadler is writing legislation to expand the Supreme Court. Jim Jordan asked if this was true. The chairman wouldn't answer. Sounds like the Democrats are running away from the bill before it's even been introduced. Yeah. Here's what they'll do. I have this tweet here from Rep. Diane DeGette. Okay, so she is the member of Congress for Colorado's 1st Congressional District, senior member of the Energy and Commerce Committee. She tweeted, breaking, we have just reintroduced our bill to ban high-capacity gun magazines. Wow, so what is that, like 100 to 200 round magazines, like drums, basically? There's no reason why any civilian needs a gun magazine that holds more than 10 rounds. Wait, more than 10? That's not standard capacity. The legislation will save lives, and Congress needs to act immediately. Look at this tweet right here. Right below it. Standard capacity for most handguns is 19 rounds. Restricting the capacity to 10 rounds will make it much more difficult for law-abiding citizens to find legal magazines and encourage more people to break the law. A sensible compromise would be limiting magazines to 20 rounds. Standard capacity, I think, is actually like 30. And I know the Democrats have tried framing the conversation to make it seem like it's not. It's high capacity. 11 rounds? No, it isn't. The police use what, a Glock 17 that holds 17? Depending on which modifications you can get a Glock 19 that a little bit bigger, can hold more rounds. So when the police, are you saying the police are running around with high capacity handguns? They're not. It's standard. This is the stupidest thing. But it shows you exactly what they want to do and exactly what they will do. And forgive me for going off on the Second Amendment stuff again, but, you know, this is stuff that I track pretty closely, considering it's actually impacting me a lot more nowadays. Let me just tell you something. This tweet from Diana DeGette is a perfect example of how this woman hates you, doesn't care about you, or anyone else in this country. The goal of this legislation, well, I'll put it this way. I'm saying that because my assumption is that she's not a stupid person. Assuming that she is of average to higher intelligence, which I believe to be the case, this is an attempt to manipulate, to lie, to cheat, and to steal. It's very simple. There are shotguns that can hold substantially more than 10 rounds. You mean to tell me that a fixed magazine shotgun is high capacity? You can't remove it. Okay. So are you going to, what's going to happen to all of the fixed magazines that hold more than 10? Oh, those are assault weapons, I guess. All right. What do you think happens when they say you can't have a magazine that holds 30 rounds? People will just bring 3 magazines with them. It's the stupidest thing ever. Do you know how easy it is to swap a magazine? It takes less than a second. Watch any one of these videos. Sure, I guess the argument is, well, that's a half a second longer than when they would be shooting their gun or whatever. And it's like, I don't think it has any substantive impact at all on guns, period. And besides, here's the funny thing. Somebody who wants to commit a crime can 3D print a magazine. And they can make their own drum. It's the stupidest thing ever. They don't care about you. They're lying to you. They're trying to make it seem like they're fighting for things. They're not actually solving any problems. So what do you think happens if they steamroll the Supreme Court, if they end the filibuster? They're going to pass insane, ridiculous law. If the cat sneezes, you get a $100 fine. What? That has nothing to do with anything. It makes no sense. If the cat sneezes while you're holding your gun, it's a $100 fine. What does that have to do with anything? No civilian needs a gun magazine that holds more than 10 rounds. Listen, there's a lot of reasons why somebody might want more than 10 rounds. And a lot of people buy weapons that have a higher capacity than that. Let's just say, first and foremost, Second Amendment is about defending a free state, which means it is about defending yourself, period, from anyone who would take your rights, be it an enemy, foreign or domestic. I believe if you were in Second Amendment style, a Second Amendment based combat of some sorts, you would absolutely want more than 10 rounds. But I'll tell you this, the bill is ridiculous because 3D printing exists and there is nothing you can do to stop it. It's the place we're in right now the guns that are being developed through 3D printers and at-home CNC and milling machines, it's insane what they're trying to do. The cat's out of the bag, okay? The technology exists. This is a lie. This is what they do. So now they're moving to pack the Supreme Court. They will absolutely annihilate gun rights. You've heard Joe Biden. He said that no amendment is absolute. Come on, man. You know, since the inception of the Bill of Rights, you know, not everybody was allowed to own a gun. Specifically referencing slaves. Brilliant, Joe Biden. My personal opinion is that if we had given the slaves the guns sooner, we could have ended that a lot sooner. And maybe we should have. Maybe every single person in this country at the time of the Second Amendment should have been allowed to have a gun. And then the slaves would have been like, nah, not going to be a slave. Well, actually, back then it wasn't. It was more click, 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 flint, whatever. You get the point. The point of the gun is that it's hard to have an enslaved population when they're all armed. And apparently Joe Biden made reference to it in a very creepy and disgusting way. That's right. In the early inception of this country, they didn't want slaves to have weapons. I would have preferred it if they did. And then following the Civil War, I'm glad that many of the former slaves were able to be armed to protect themselves from the racist racist Democrats at the time who were in the Klan or who wanted Jim Crow, and they wanted to defend themselves, and they had every right to do so. The Second Amendment applies to everyone. Anyway, not to go off on a Second Amendment thing. The point is, I think it's just the most visceral example of what they're going to do with the Supreme Court. If they break the filibuster and they pack the court, I assure you, they'll pass legislation banning the most ridiculous things. Muzzle brakes are bad. It's like, why? What? You should you only bolt action rifles. So you want better accuracy at long range? It's ridiculous. 3D printing exists. You can't stop it. They're going to do it anyway. We should ban the AR-15, they yell. There are other guns. There are guns other than AR-15s. You realize that are semi-automatic and they function like that. Well, then, you know, they've even called for banning semi-auto. And it's like, revolvers exist, dude. Shut your mouth. These people are insane. What they're really saying is they don't know. They don't care. They just want power and they will do whatever they can to get it. So long as they create this wedge issue about guns, people will just cheer and jumping up and down for whatever BS. I'll tell you what will happen. You ban magazines that are more than 10 rounds. People will just have 500 magazines on the ready and they'll carry them. And then you go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, click, click, 1, 2, 3, 4. It's insane. It's absolutely insane. Once the Supreme Court is packed, assuming it will be, I don't necessarily think it will be because Manchin, regardless of filibuster, you're not going to see every Democrat supporting this. Then they'll get a lawsuit on, you know, gun rights, the Second Amendment. And the Supreme Court will say the Second Amendment does not protect your right to bear arms. Bye. Gone. There you go. I suppose we can only sit back, wait and see. And I think it won't fly because of Manchin. So for the time being, it's not like the apocalypse is here, but you see them trying to do it. I'll leave it there. Next segment's coming up at 1 p.m. on this channel. Thanks for hanging out and I will see you all then.